So I posted a video a week or two ago about the Antelope Orion Gen 4 and what upgrades or differences there was over the Gen 3. Well, one of the bugbears that I mentioned was the fact that it had a similar issue to the Gen 3, whereby you had to give up two outputs if you were a Pro Tools user for use with the monitors. Now, Antelope Audio reached out to me about this, and their product manager wanted to jump on the phone and discuss it and see if we could find a solution for it. So I agreed to it. We had a great chat, and we discussed all things Antelope. And however, the net result of this was Antelope agree that there is an issue for Pro Tools users. Now, other DAWs don't appear to suffer this problem. I know I used Logic for a while and that didn't have this issue, but with Pro Tools, it is a problem. So I wanted to give you a bit of an update on this. Now, I am not saying by any means that this is Antelope's problem. I think a lot of this issue lies with Avid as well, because the way Pro Tools works with hardware inserts is very, very rigid. You have to have the same input as you do output. So one has to go to one, out of two, into two. You cannot change this in Pro Tools, it's hard set. Whereas in Logic, for instance, it doesn't really care where you send audio. You can send it out of seven and receive it back in on nine, and it makes no difference. So for people who are using Logic, and I'm not familiar with Cubase enough to comment on that, I can't speak to Cubase, but certainly as far as Logic goes, you shouldn't have an issue with this. This is purely a Pro Tools issue. So how do you get around it? Well, with the Gen 4 having such a massive amount of I/O, 128 I/O potentially over Thunderbolt, that does mean that for most users, you're actually probably not going to be using all 128 at the same time. It's very unlikely that that's going to happen. So I've developed a workaround for this very problem, and I'm going to show you what I do with it, and then maybe that might help you out. So let's jump into the Antelope software, and I'll show you how this works. So here you can see that all of these options that you have can be hidden at will. Now, the thing is, if you look here at your monitor outs, which are here, I have mine set to 33 and 34. So currently, I am using all 32 analog ins and outs. So you see here, though, you have DAW ins going up to 128, which means that your DAW will see all 128 available. But most people aren't going to be using all of this. And if you're just using the analog I/O, then what you can actually do is if you go to the top row and you put DAW out 33 to 64, you can take 33 and 34, like so, and drag them down to your monitor outs. This means that when you open Pro Tools, you'll have to go into the I/O setup wizard, and you will have to set 33 and 34 as your monitor outs. Now, so here we are in the I/O setup wizard of Pro Tools, and as you can see, at the moment, there are outs all the way up to 32. Sorry, ins, out to 32. Outputs go to 34. So what you can do is set your monitors to out 33 and 34, and that leaves out 1 and 2 free, which what would be usually used by the Orion. So if I look at my hardware inserts, you can see I've got everything down on there, and this allows me to use 1 and 2, 3 and 4, etc. Let me zoom back out. So at present, that's the only way around this problem, is to use some outputs, some DAW outs that you're not actually using, and utilize those for the monitors. Now, I did ask the question to Antelope, would it be possible in the software for you to create an additional two software outputs, which were essentially dummy outputs that you could route from Pro Tools to the monitor outs, which to me would be a very simple solution, I guess, to the problem. Now, unfortunately, that's not possible. And the reason that isn't possible is because of the the bandwidth on Thunderbolt. So because they've got 128 potential ins and outs, they just physically cannot have any more. And also, the way the hardware is designed and the limitations in the chipsets and things like that means that they can't really do this. It's not a viable solution. And if they could, the amount of R&D it would take to make such a thing happen is not really worth it. So the long and short of the story is the Gen 4 better than the Gen 3? Yes. So with the Antelope Orion Gen 3, you had 64 I/O available, which did make your options more limited. But in the Gen 4, you've got 128 available. So this gives you way more options, because even if you were to expand the Gen 4, as I am planning to do by adding a second Gen 4 for 64 I/O, I've still got spares that I will likely never use. You know, for instance, you've got outputs there for Lightpipe, SPDIF, all these kinds of things. I'll probably never use them, to be honest, and I think a lot of you guys out there probably will never use them. So I think between all of the available input options you've got, or output options, you'll find a spare pair that you don't need that you can use for the monitor outs. Some of you may already know this information, but I thought I would share it and show you how I do it in case somebody is having the same problem I was having and is a little bit stuck with it. There is the categoric answer for you. No, you cannot set the outputs to be additional to what is already in the software, but you can assign other outputs to work around the problem for Pro Tools users. There you go, small update. Thanks a lot for joining me today, and I'll catch you in the next video. Be well.